Hello again, and welcome to BTE Technologies. I'm Walter Vasquez, Vice President, Products Group. The sit-to-stand function is one of the most common movements of everyday life. It is the beginning and end of our daily routines. From getting out of bed, getting into a car, occupying our workspace, or sitting at the dinner table. Your patient's ability to safely and confidently perform this basic movement is very important to their short and long-term health. Other therapeutic modalities depend on the patient's independent ability to perform sit-to-stand activities. For many patients, this basic movement becomes much more difficult with cardiorespiratory and musculoskeletal deconditioning. We all know the common contributors to deconditioning: illness, injury, age, and immobility. But now we face a new factor, the COVID-19 health crisis. Patients recovering from these conditions will need carefully planned treatment for long-term recovery. For those that need assistance regaining their strength and balance for sit-to-stand, you have a very powerful rehab solution in your clinic, the PrimusRS. Today, we're going to show you the sit-to-stand template on the PrimusRS. Unlike other resistance-based equipment, the clinical innovation of the PrimusRS delivers a reduced assistance method. That means that instead of increasing resistance as the patient progresses, we're going to reduce the resistance while performing the same amount of work. Reduce assistance training. It provokes and engages muscle groups to do more work and more of the work. It can help reduce the dependence of your patient in assistive mobility devices. It will increase muscle recruitment through the kinetic chain. It can help provide a positive psychological impact on your patients by increasing their confidence that they can perform the desired functional outcomes. At BTE, we always use data-driven decision-making when creating an exercise. With objective measurements and progress reports, you can deliver safe, individualized rehab experiences that builds your patient's confidence. Now, let's see how we can use the PrimusRS to deliver effective sit-to-stand dosing and exercising.
Hi, I'm Colleen from Therapy Spark. Today, we're going to do a sit-to-stand exercise with the PrimusRS. This exercise activates key muscle groups and improves the movement patterns, balance, and stability for this functional activity. This is extremely important to building confidence in elderly patients who are at risk for falling. It is also beneficial to get patients up, mobilized, and independent while recovering from cardiorespiratory conditions. Let's get started. These are the tools that you'll need: the PrimusRS, the cable attachment, a chair, preferably one without arms, the waist strap, and a sit-to-stand treatment template. Set your chair out in front of the system with a cable angled towards it. Ask the patient to position the belt around the very top of their legs and pull to a snug fit. To establish a baseline, we're going to start with the resistance at 30% of the patient's body weight. You can use more or less resistance based on your patient's needs. This weighted resistance provides support during sitting and a de-weighted lift while standing. This baseline evaluation determines the patient's work and power outputs. These measurements become the starting point on the road to successful rehab. While the patient performs the exercise, the system will calculate the patient's power output every 5 seconds. This output is indicated by the blue bars in the screen. Power measurements are very important as they illustrate the movement quality. Blue bars of similar heights mean consistent quality outputs. The system objectively calculates the power and work being done and provides visual indicators for the patient to stay in range. The goal is to maintain the blue bars within this target range between the red lines. Having this visual goal and data-driven, real-time feedback helps the patient feel more engaged with your rehab program. Quantifying fatigue has traditionally been an elusive objective for therapists. We all know the power output is one of the indicators to measure quality of movement. As patients become fatigued, their power output will diminish. The Primus will help you objectively quantify a good stopping point in the exercise. Generally, a drop in power of about 25% is an appropriate stopping point. After identifying the baseline, we now have an objective and data-based starting point. Following the reduced resistance methods, we will start this exercise at 25% of their body weight, down from the initial 30%. We will also assign a work goal by adding 10% from the initial work results during the baseline testing. Basically, we're decreasing the amount of assistance and increasing the amount of work. The patient will be doing more work overall and more of the work. Here we have the patient progress report. This shows the work being done in the previous sessions. And you can see the percentage increase of the work and power. If the patient generates power outputs that are consistent within plus or minus 5% of their previous sessions, then they can progress to the next level of lowered resistance. For each progressive round of treatment, you will decrease the resistance by about 5 percentage points until the patient is performing a sit-to-stand with almost no assistance, or as little as 9 pounds. The sit-to-stand movement may seem simple, but it is one of the most important functions of daily living. Older patients who are frail or suffering from cardiorespiratory or musculoskeletal deconditioning are especially vulnerable to falling during sit-to-stand movements. With the PrimusRS, you can gradually build their strength, stability, and confidence, so your patients will feel more secure as they go throughout their day.
I feel very secure during this exercise. I've had an increase in strength and stamina in my legs and increased confidence as I go about my daily routines at home or at work. It's really good for my balance.
I hope you found this beneficial for your patients. At BTE, our mission is to help you provide better outcomes. Just like you, we're creating more and more digital connections with our rehab community. So I'm inviting you to share your own rehab success stories with us or creative solutions you have developed. Grab your phone and tell us how you made a difference in your patients' lives with your BTE. Connect with us on social media at BTE Tech or email us at interact@btetechnologies.com. And check out our blog, Therapy Spark, for articles, ebooks, and videos by rehab professionals like you. And thank you.